Hey, you guys! I am back with another video! I hope you guys are doing well. This is LaTersa Blakely, and I am here with the Living Your Best Life because it is my deepest desire to see you win in every area of your life, to see and help you believe that once and for all, you are absolutely enough. No ifs, ands, buts about it. But listen, today we're talking all about living your wildest dreams. Are y'all with me? Are y'all ready to live your wildest dreams? Well, you are right on this video today, so stay tuned. Grab you a glass of wine and get comfy. So today's topic is all about how to live your wildest dreams. Here's the thing. You know that thing that you've been wanting to do for years. You know that thing that you've always been wanting to do. Where here's the thing. It's not just going to fall out the sky for you. It's not just going to blow out the wind and say, poof, here I am. It's not going to do that. You have to put in the effort and time and work to get this thing done. To have, you know, they say make things manifest. It takes work. You and God got to work together as a team to make this stuff pop off. I'm a living witness, y'all. So listen, the first thing in order for you to live your wildest dreams is, hold up, something is wrong. Okay. Hold on. You know how your lip gloss be on for so long and then it start acting crazy? That's what it's trying to do. Yeah. But anyway, the first thing you want to do is follow your bliss. What is that thing that makes your soul come alive? What is that thing that makes you so stinking happy? You can do it in your sleep. You can do it even if you didn't get paid for it. What is that thing? Some of you guys need to go back to your childhood and find out what is that thing that brings you joy. What is that thing that you could do in your sleep? You can do even if you didn't get paid for it. Some of you guys been wanting to move. Some of you guys been wanting to branch out and start your business. Whatever that thing is, it's time now to follow that bliss. Do y'all hear me? It's time for you to follow your bliss. The second thing in order for you to live your wildest dreams, you got to become best friends with the two-letter words. Can you guess what it is? Can you guess what it is? No. You got to learn how to say no. You got to get so comfortable saying no. You got to get so comfortable saying no and mean it. And you don't need to say no explanation. You don't need to give an explanation on nothing. The only thing you need to do is understand that you said no. No is a complete sentence. And sometimes that's living your wildest dream because you've been such a people pleaser for so long, you don't even know how to say no. You say yes even when you want to say no, but you say it because you don't want people to be mad at you. You don't want people to think you are that and, oh my God, who she thinks she is. Whatever. They're going to say what they want to say regardless, but you got to be bold enough to say no and mean it. And that's it. And they'll catch up. You ain't got to explain yourself. You ain't got to say nothing. I'm telling you, learn how to say no. Some of you guys, that's going to set you free today. Learn how to say no. It's going to feel a little awkward at first because, you know, you're so used to people, so used to your family, especially your family members. You're so used to them. You're so used to telling them yes, and they're so used to you doing everything. And then when you start to say no, oh, honey, oh, you're going to get some eyes turned. Oh, you're going to get a few things said to you. Oh, you're going to get some all kind of eyes rolled at you. But this is what I'm telling you. If you want to live your wildest dreams, you got to become best friends with the word no. The third thing, in order for you to live your wildest dreams, you got to not be afraid to take a chance on you. Can I just share with you guys? I recently moved. You guys moved from my little small environment. And I finally moved to the state that I've always wanted to be in since I was a teenager. Do y'all know how freaking good that feels? Was I scared? Yes. Heck yes. I got two kids. Yes. And it's just me now. So yes, I was scared. But I did it anyway because I wanted to take another chance on me. I cannot leave this earth without leaving a mark on this earth. God did not bless me or you to overcome what you've overcome for you to keep your mouth shut, for you to just be quiet. I'm not that quiet woman. I'm not that woman that's, oh, so quiet and don't want shot. That ain't me. See, I'm that loud woman, that woman that loves to make you laugh, that woman that keeps you on your toes. That's me. I'm not that quiet person. So whoever you are, whatever it is you want to do, now is the time for you to take a chance on you. What do you have to lose? You won't know unless you try. If I can do it at 41, start all over again, I know you can do it. I'm rooting for you. Because sometimes you have to leave your familiar to get to where God wants you to be. And so I'm encouraging you today. Leave me a comment below. What's that thing you've been wanting to do? Where have you wanted to travel and you haven't done it yet? I'm telling you guys, it's gonna really make a world of a difference in the way you live your life. And then the last and final tip is, give yourself permission to live your own life. Stop trying to live your life for everybody else. Stop trying to do things because mother didn't want you to, or your hubby wants you to. Now let me just give an FYI. When you are married, you and your husband are one. So you may have your separate dreams, but I'm not telling you to go out there and do something crazy and you and your hubby be hitting, bumping heads. Tersa ain't telling you to do that. What I'm saying to you is, whatever that thing is you've always wanted to do, sit down and talk it over with your hubby. If he loves you the way you say he does, he will want to support you. He will truly want to see you happy, living your best life. And that all goes back to you being comfortable in your own skin. So do what makes, first of all, I'm all about peace. Whatever makes peace in your house, that's what you stick to. But if you want to live your wildest dream, you're going to have to communicate. Communication is the key to any successful relationship. So don't say, LaTersa said, I'm going to do this and I'm going to care. I don't care who. No, boo. No, no. LaTersa ain't said that. I said, speak it over with your hubby. Talk it over and y'all come to some type of mutual agreement, because I'm like this. Listen, I've been on the wifey side before, and I'm a big dreamer. And so in my first marriage, well, that's the only marriage I've ever had. But anyway, yet. Let's throw that out there. Yet, because the best is yet to come. My Prince Charming or whoever, he on his way, boo. But in God's timing. But what I'm saying to you is, you are an individual and you had goals and dreams way before all of this other stuff took place. Go back to that childhood like mine. Go back to the things that brought you joy as a kid and see if that'll help you maneuver to what that thing is you want to do to help you live your best life. So today, I hope that something I said blesses you. I hope that it helps you to, you know, live your best life. And the only way you're going to do it, you got to take a chance on you. So listen, if you are on Instagram, make sure you follow me on Instagram, LaTersa Speaks. Make sure you subscribe to my channel, Living Your Best Life. And hit that notification button so that you will be the first one to get the goods on when I upload. But in the meantime, I hope you guys have an amazing, wonderful, and prosperous day. God bless. I love you guys. And so does God. Mm-hmm.